Hello friends, welcome to anujindal.in. So in this video, I am going to discuss some important numerical questions from the topic of ratio analysis. So you know, in paper 2 of SEBI grade A examination, there are 6 subjects. So one of those 6 subjects is commerce and accountancy. So we are going to discuss questions on ratio analysis. So let us begin. So question 1 says, from the following information, calculate net profit ratio. So you are given some information and you have to calculate the net profit ratio. So gross profit is 1/4 of the cost. So cost means cost of goods sold, okay, COGS, and sales is 2 lakh. Indirect expenses are given to be 12,000. Okay, so how we will do this? So you know, there is a formula which says cost of goods sold plus gross profit is equal to sales. Okay, now we can assume cost of goods sold to be x, so gross profit will be 1/4 of x, or x by 4, and sales are given to be as 2 lakhs. So if you solve this, x will come out to be 2 lakhs multiplied by 4 by 5, so this will be 1,60,000. So cost of goods sold comes out to be rupees 1,60,000, and now gross profit is 1/4 of 1,60,000, which will be 40,000. So gross profit comes out to be 40,000. Now from this gross profit, when you deduct the indirect expenses of 12,000, you will get the net profit. So net profit comes out to be rupees 28,000. Okay, so we have got the net profit. Now how to calculate the net profit ratio? So it is simply net profit divided by sales into 100. So net profit is given as 28,000, sales are 2 lakhs, okay, into 100. So if you will solve this, this will come out to be 14%. This will come out to be 14%. So net profit ratio is option C, 14%. I hope this is very clear. Moving on to the next question. Question 2, current ratio is given as 2.5:1 and liquid ratio is given as 1:1, and stock is rupees 60,000. You need to calculate the value of current liability. So current ratio is basically current assets upon current liabilities, and liquid ratio is equal to liquid assets upon current liability. This formula you should know. Now the ratio is given as 2.5:1. So current assets upon current liabilities is equal to 2.5, and liquid ratio is liquid assets upon current liabilities is equal to 1. Now if you do the cross multiplication, so current assets is equal to 2.5 times current liabilities, and liquid assets are equal to current liabilities. So liquid assets and current liabilities are equal. So in this first equation, you can substitute liquid assets in place of current liabilities. So current assets will become 2.5 times liquid assets. Okay, I hope up till here there is no problem. Now stock is given as 60,000. So basically the difference between current assets and liquid assets is due to stock and prepaid expenses. So from the current assets, if you deduct the stock, and there are no prepaid expenses, so we cannot deduct prepaid expenses. So current assets minus stock comes out to be liquid assets, because stock is not a part of liquid assets. Okay, so let me write above, let me erase this. Okay, so you have got current assets minus stock is equal to liquid assets. So in place of current assets, I can write 2.5 times liquid assets. Okay, so 2.5 times liquid assets minus stock is 60,000 is equal to liquid assets. Now let me bring liquid assets to this side. So 2.5 times liquid assets minus liquid assets is equal to 60,000. So 1.5 times liquid assets is equal to 60,000. So liquid assets comes out to be 40,000. So the value of liquid assets has come out to be rupees 40,000, and we know from the second equation that liquid assets are equal to current liabilities. So current liabilities are also equal to 40,000. So the correct answer is option A, rupees 40,000. The value of current liabilities is also rupees 40,000. I hope this is very, very clear to you. Now moving on to the next question, question 3. From the following information, calculate inventory turnover ratio. So you are given some information. Revenue from operations is given as 4 lakh. So revenue from operations is basically your sales. Average inventory is given as 55,000. And the rate of gross loss on revenue from operations is given as 10%. Okay. So what is the formula of inventory turnover ratio? Inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold upon average inventory. So average inventory we are given, we need to calculate the cost of goods sold. Okay. So basically we know that cost of goods sold plus gross profit is equal to sales. Okay. And cost of goods sold minus gross loss. If there is a loss, then we have to deduct. Cost of goods sold minus the loss is equal to sales. So in this case, we are given loss. So loss is 10% of sales. So 10% of 4 lakh is equal to 40,000. Okay. So COGS minus 40,000, which is the gross loss, is equal to 4 lakhs, which is the sales. So COGS comes out to be 4,40,000. I hope this is clear. Now, if I want to calculate the inventory turnover ratio, it will be 4,40,000 divided by the average inventory, which is given as 55,000. So this will come out to be 8 times. So inventory turnover ratio, the value of inventory turnover ratio is 8 times. Option C. I hope this is very, very clear to you. Now moving on to the next question. Question 4. Calculate total assets to debt ratio from the below data. So you are given some data, you have to calculate total assets to debt ratio. So what is the formula of this ratio? The formula is total assets divided by long term debt, or you can say non-current liabilities. Long term debt can also be called as non-current liabilities. So this is the formula to calculate total assets to debt ratio. So we are given total liabilities as rupees 12 lakh. Shareholders fund is given as 2 lakh. Reserve and surplus is given as rupees 50,000. Current assets are given as rupees 5 lakh. And working capital is given as rupees 1 lakh. So in this question, we need two things. We need the value of total assets and we need the value of non-current liabilities. So we are given total liabilities. So we have to deduct current liabilities from total liabilities in order to calculate non-current liabilities. And how can we calculate current liabilities? So we know current assets minus current liabilities is equal to working capital. So current assets is given as rupees 5 lakh. Current liabilities we have to calculate, and working capital is given to as rupees 1 lakh. So the value of current liabilities comes out to be rupees 4 lakh. So what will be the value of non-current liabilities? It will be total liabilities minus current liabilities, which is 12 lakh minus 4 lakh. This comes out to be rupees 8 lakh. So we have got our denominator. We have got our denominator. The value of long-term debt or the value of non-current liabilities is rupees 8 lakh. Now we need to calculate the value of total assets. So basically, what is total assets? Let me write above. So total assets basically is equal to total liabilities plus shareholders fund. Total liabilities plus shareholders fund is equal to total assets. Okay. So in this question, you will see you are given total liabilities, you are given shareholders fund, and you are also given reserve and surplus. But we will ignore reserve and surplus. Why? Because reserve and surplus is already a part of shareholders fund. You are given this to confuse you. Okay. So reserve and surplus is already a part of shareholders fund. So total assets will be equal to total liabilities, which is 12 lakh, and shareholders fund, which is 2 lakh. So the value comes out to be 14 lakh. So the value of total asset is 14 lakh and the value of non-current liabilities is 8 lakh. So the ratio comes out to be 14 divided by 8, which is equal to 1.75:1. So the value of total assets to debt ratio is 1.75:1. The correct answer is option C. I hope this is clear. Moving on to the next question, question 5. From the following data, compute inventory turnover ratio. So inventory turnover ratio is basically COGS upon average inventory. Okay. So you are given opening stock 58,000, purchases 5,02,000, return outwards is 18,000. So return outwards is basically purchase return. Okay. Then sales are given 6,53,000, return inwards is 13,000. So return inwards is sales return. And gross profit is given as 25% on sales. Okay. Now let us see this question. So first of all, you can calculate net sales. So what will be the value of net sales? It will be 6,53,000 minus sales return, which is 13,000. So the value of net sales come out to be 6,40,000. Now gross profit is given to you as 25% of sales. So gross profit will be 1/4 into 6,40,000, which will come out to be rupees 1,60,000. Now you can calculate the cost of goods sold. So net sales, which is 6,40,000 minus gross profit, which is 1,60,000, it comes out to be 4,80,000. So your cost of goods sold, COGS, is 4,80,000. So we have got our numerator. Now we need to calculate the denominator, and the denominator is the average inventory. So we have the opening inventory, but we also need the closing inventory. So we know opening stock plus net purchase minus closing stock is equal to cost of goods sold. Now opening stock is given to us as 58,000. Now what is the net purchase? So purchase is 5,02,000. And purchase return is 18,000. So we will add 5,02,000 and we will deduct 18,000 minus closing stock is equal to COGS, which is given to us as we have calculated 4,80,000 COGS. Okay. Now, if you solve this equation, you will get closing stock is equal to, this will be 5,60,000 minus 4,80,000, it will be 80,000. 80,000 minus 18 is equal to 62,000. So the value of closing stock will come out to be rupees 60,000. So let me erase above. So you have got the value of closing stock as rupees 60,000. So what will be the value of average inventory or average stock? It will be opening stock, which is 58,000. Plus closing stock, which is 62,000, divide by 2, this will come out to be 60,000. So this is the value of average inventory. Now the value of inventory turnover ratio, it will be COGS, which is 4,80,000, divide by average inventory, which is equal to 60,000. So this will come out to be 8 times. So inventory turnover ratio comes out to be 8 times, which is option B. I hope this is very, very clear to you. So this inventory turnover ratio is very, very important. Now next question, question number 6. Stock turnover ratio is given as 6 times. Average stock is given as 8,000. And selling price is 25% above cost. You have to calculate the amount of gross profit. So we know stock turnover ratio or inventory turnover ratio is equal to COGS upon average stock. So COGS we can calculate. Stock turnover ratio is 6 and average stock is 8,000. So COGS comes out to be rupees 48,000. Okay. Now selling price is 25% above cost. So selling price is 1.25 times into 48,000. So what will be the 1.25 times of 48,000? So selling price will come out to be rupees 60,000. If you solve this, it will come out to be rupees 60,000. Okay. Now you have to calculate the gross profit. So how to calculate the gross profit? So we know COGS plus gross profit is equal to selling price. So COGS is 48,000. Gross profit we have to calculate. Selling price we have calculated 60,000. So gross profit will come out to be rupees 12,000. Okay, so gross profit is rupees 12,000. So the correct answer is option D, rupees 12,000. I hope this is clear. This was a pretty simple question. Now moving to the last question for the day. The budgeted annual sales of a company is rupees 80 lakhs and 25% of the same is cash sale. If the average amount of debtors of the company is rupees 5 lakh, calculate the average collection period of credit sales. You have to calculate the average collection period. Now, how to calculate the average collection period? So basically, average collection period you can calculate in months also, and you can calculate in terms of days also. So if you are calculating in months, let's say if we are calculating in months, then our numerator becomes 12. But if we are calculating in days, then our numerator becomes 365. So 12 divided by debtor turnover ratio. 12 divided by debtors turnover ratio is the formula of average collection period. Now, what is the formula to calculate debtor turnover ratio? So debtor turnover ratio is net credit sales divided by average trade receivable. So trade receivable is basically debtors plus bills receivable. So in this particular question, we are not given bills receivable. So we will only consider the debtors. Okay. So debtor turnover ratio, it will be equal to net credit sales. So net credit sales is 75% of 80 lakhs because 25% is cash sale. So the remaining 75% is credit sale. And average trade receivable will be equal to average debtors, which is given to us as 5 lakhs. Okay. Now, if you further solve this, so 75% of 80 lakhs comes out to be 60 lakhs. And in the denominator, we have 5 lakhs. So this will come out to be 12. So debtor turnover ratio comes out to be 12 times. Now, we can now easily calculate our average collection period. Okay. So average collection period is equal to 12 into our debtor turnover ratio, which has come out to be again 12. So 12 divided by 12 comes out to be 1. And as I told you, when we take 12 in the numerator, the average collection period comes out in the months. So the average collection period is 1 month. Okay. So the correct answer will be option B, 1 month. I hope this is very, very clear to you. So friends, I have tried to cover questions from different types of ratios which can be asked in the examination from the topic of ratio analysis. So there are a lot of ratios like liquidity ratios, solvency ratios, turnover ratios, profitability ratios. So all the ratios are very, very important. So if you have liked this video, then do subscribe to our channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular notifications and updates. If you have any query or any doubt, then you can always ask in the comment section below. All the very best, friends. Have a nice day.